welcome to the official catch-up. Today I've got Niall Kelly of Gala Fairydean Rovers. How are you doing, Nelly?
I'm good, mate. How are you?
Aye, good. Just as I mentioned, you know, firing through these. Spoke to the gaffer, obviously. I've reached out to a few of the Gala boys and that, so hopefully we can sort of continue what we're doing. But as I said, mate, I appreciate you coming on. How are you keeping anyway? How are you getting through this?
Doing all right. I'm working as normal, eh? So apart from the football and everything else outside, just normal working.
That's not too bad then. Aye, there's a few boys obviously still working in that, and it's good that they've got that, eh? So, but in terms of Gala, obviously, you guys have, I said to the gaffer, obviously, I was a wee bit worried about you this season, more the change going on, but you guys have been pretty decent, actually.
I think even throughout the season, the squad's changed quite a bit from what we started with to even now. We've lost and added different boys, eh? But we're doing well.
Yeah, and in terms of yourself, mate, I've said it to you before, but I think you've been unlucky with the top 11 because Gala have been kind of in and out with Berwick for that 11th spot. But I think you've done fantastically well, Nelly.
I appreciate it, mate. Cheers.
Aye, there's a few, you know, with Gala, there's a few younger boys, obviously, like Ching and Xander Murray, obviously, doing really well. I know he's a wee bit older, but, you know, the Gala team's been quite impressive for you just sort of gelling together this season.
Nah, I think for even with our position, there's certain games, if we'd seen it out, we could be in a whole different spot, you know what I mean? Like games against Gretna and that. If we see it out, the last 10, 15 minutes could be in a different position completely.
And in terms of yourself, who do you support, Nelly, if you don't mind me asking?
I'm a Celtic fan, mate.
Celtic. So are you hoping that, obviously, Celtic get the title and all that sort of stuff?
Hopefully. So I don't know what will happen. It's a weird one. Aye. Depends, if you're at the bottom, you're not wanting it to finish you. If you're at the top, you are.
Aye. And well, it's not really going to affect Gala too much, but what do you think should happen, you know, with all this? Are you hoping that, obviously, well, seeing you're a Celtic fan, you're probably wanting Celtic to get the title and stuff, but...
For Celtic or for a Liverpool or something, you'd want them to get the title, but it's a bit different for the Lowland League, where it'd been a lot closer, eh?
Aye, as I mentioned, obviously, I think these guys are doing a decent job. What's it like playing at Netherdale? It's obviously a fantastic facility, and the stadium is pretty special.
It's a good club all round, to be fair, with the people in the background and that. I've not really been at a club before that is like that, you know what I mean? Like a community like that. So even people like Debbie and that behind the scenes, they do a lot, even through the Twitter and stuff like that. So it's a good club to be at.
And what's the travel like down on like match days and obviously you know for training and stuff like that?
Yeah, it's just normal now. We've got a wee car club. We just meet up at the Gala and that. So me, Ching, Levi, Xander.
Oh, that's not too bad then. Obviously,
even the cars changed a wee bit throughout the season. We've lost a couple of boys, but it's an alright journey. But
aye, that's good then. But in terms of your career, mate, to be honest, I don't really know a lot of what you were doing before, Nelly, before Gala. Sort of, were you in pro youth? Were you playing for any of the sort of league sides at youth level?
When I was younger, I was at Dunfermline and Livy and that. But recently, from 15, I was at Tyne. I was at Tyne 20s, and then at 16, I went up to the first team. So for the last 2-3 years, I was at Tyne playing first team there.
And how was that? Obviously, I spoke to Callum Elliott recently, obviously, Tynecastle manager. It's not a club I know quite, you know, a lot about. Obviously, I know the sort of focus is on youth. Do you think that sort of time benefited you as a footballer?
Definitely. I mean, I was playing first team at 16, so it was definitely better than playing 20s or 19s or whatever. So I think it got better for that, definitely. I mean, I had Callum just at the end there, and obviously, they're doing a good job down there at Tyne.
Aye, absolutely, and he's obviously, you know, with their situation, they're doing so well in the sort of first division conference. They're well ahead, and I know Callum's a wee bit frustrated. You know, I think he wants to play it out and deserve the title, but he's well ahead basically, and it'll be a shame if you know if it's null and void and he doesn't get up.
Aye, definitely.
Aye, obviously the news before this was obviously the West of Scotland. Are you looking forward to perhaps maybe? I don't know if there's going to be a cup competition or anything like that, but are you looking forward to some of the West teams coming in the pyramid?
It'd be good, especially if there's a cup competition just for different teams, eh? For your usual, I mean, you're getting drawn in the cup where teams are usually playing the league, eh? So.
And that's the main thing. I don't know I don't know what's going to happen with that, if there is going to be a much interaction between the likes of West of Scotland or East of Scotland and the Lowland League, but I'm hoping that there will be, like, so I think it would be good to have a sort of cup competition.
There'll be a lot of good teams for it that way, like.
Oh, aye, definitely, mate, definitely. In terms of yourself, obviously, are you keeping fit? Are you still speaking to lads in the chats and whatnot?
I've been speaking to the boys, not as much as you would if you're in training and that, but I've been going for runs personally, that's about it, just trying to keep ticking over, only 5Ks and that.
Good. And what's it like around where, I think, well, obviously I know you're from my sort of neck of the woods, but are you finding it easy with the runs, or is there people getting in your way, or are you trying to keep your distance and whatnot?
Nah, I've been working back shift, so I've been going after that late night, nobody out to be fair, and I'm filming.
Oh, that's good, because I know some people have had that issue where, you know, you're taking a run and obviously you have to run on the road because keeping the distance and stuff. But no, mate, as I say, I appreciate you coming on and everything, and you know, a good chat around the leagues. I've reached out to a few of the other Gala boys, and it's a team I've always sort of liked. Obviously, I know a few guys like Ching and that from Kelly under 20s, and I've been really impressed with Xander Murray and obviously Scott Taylor McKenzie as well. Yeah, always appreciate the boys coming on and chatting.
One thing, big Gareth, what a signing. Got to give him a shout out.
Gareth Roger, I said that to the gaffer, eh? I thought it was a brilliant signing. I think he's changed his at the back from, well, I saw you fairly early in the season, and I saw you against, I think, Shire or something like that, and what a difference he's made.
Aye, definitely.
And even, I noticed, obviously, Ben Herdman, I saw a wee bit of Ben last season. He was obviously on loan at Coldstream for a wee bit, but even in terms of the whole back line, I would say that he's done a job for you, it's like.
Aye, Ben's been brilliant, to be fair.
Absolutely, mate. And as I say, mate, I appreciate the chat, and thanks for coming on. Again, you're probably busy and stuff like that with work and whatnot, so I'll let you go on. But welcome anytime. Stay safe, pal, and I'll hopefully see Gala soon.
Cheers for Matt. Have a meal on, mate. I appreciate it.